हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, गुड मॉर्निंग। दिस इज़ कामेश्वरी। वेलकम टू वीडियो लेक्चर क्लासेस। चिल्ड्रेन, आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड द ज्योग्राफी पार्ट 1, 2, 3, 4 लेसन्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द लेसन वाटर। ऑलरेडी आई एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द वाटर बॉडीज ऑफ द अर्थ, व्हाट वी कॉल एज हाइड्रोस्फीयर। If you want to live on this earth, we need water. Water is one of the most important substances that are needed for plants, animals also. We cannot lead our life, day-to-day life, without water. Water makes up more than half of your body weight also. Without water, all organisms in the world die. Water is necessary not only for drinking but also for our day-to-day life processes like bathing, cooking, cleaning and washing. We cannot imagine our life without water. Earth is a blue planet. What is the reason? Blue planet means nearly 70% of area is covered by water. That's why we call our planet as a blue planet. How the planet Earth got as water? So many reasons are there. The Earth gets water from the rain and fog through the precipitation. What are the different forms of precipitation? I will say you again to you. Okay, we get water from the rain, okay, waterfalls, oceans. That water stored in oceans, rivers, ponds, lakes and streams. Oceans are the large salt bodies of the earth. Those are all called the oceans. Next, rivers. Rivers are born in somewhere and it flows to downwards and it connects it. Those rivers connect with oceans, our base and anywhere. Ponds are, we have to find out in anywhere. You know very well, lakes, streams, these are all the water bodies. We get water from these are all things, but some areas water is fresh. In some areas the water is different, salty. Suppose ocean water is salty. Remaining ponds, streams, rivers, this water is fresh water. Okay, how the earth receive this water? Through the water cycle. Yes, what is the meaning of the water cycle? Means, you know very well, the sun's heat causes evaporation of water into vapor. Then the water vapor cools down. It condenses and forms clouds. From these it may fall on the land or sea in the form of rain, snow or sleet. So this is called the water cycle. In this water cycle only some of the processes are there, that is evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Now, you see, now first, the large water bodies on the earth are called oceans. A lot of water is stagnated in the oceans. Due to sun's heat, water evaporates. That evaporated water mixes into the air. This water vapor goes up in the form of clouds. When those clouds touches the cool area, it condenses like a water. It may be at the time fall on the earth in the form of rain. So rain, snow, sleet, these are called the precipitation. These are the forms of precipitation. Okay, now once the clouds reach the saturation point, the water comes down in the form of precipitation. Different forms of precipitation means rain, snow, dew, sleet, these are the points. Rate of evaporation depends upon the sun's heat and absorption capacity of the air. The process in which the water changes its form and circulates between land, ocean, air, this is called the water cycle. Okay children, the water, in the water cycle you get water. It is the cycle, it is a continuous process. It is a continuous process. The same water that existed centuries ago still exists today. So many years back the water was evaporated. Those water vapor clouds going the long distances, in those areas people received the same water. The water used to irrigate a field in Haryana may have flowed down the Amazon River 100 years ago. What are the major sources of fresh water? Are the rivers, ponds, springs and glaciers. Okay, how we are all using the water nowadays? Distribution of water. We are all know very well, 3/4 of the earth's surface is covered by the water. Total among the earth is 100%. Among this 100%, 70.9% is covered with water. Remaining 29%, one is land area. If there is more water than land, but so many members are facing the scarcity of water. Why? What happened? Is all the water on the earth available to us? This table, first you read this table, after you say to me the answer of that question. Among you have 100% of water is available on this earth. This 100% of water is distributed between the water areas. What are those? One by one I will explain. Ocean areas captures 97.3% of water. Among 100%, 97.3% of water is stagnated in the oceans. Ice caps, 2.0. Groundwater, 0.68. Freshwater lakes, 0.009. Inland seas and salt lakes, 0.009. And atmosphere, 0.0019. And rivers, 0.0001. So you count these overall percentages, total you have to find out 100%. So here 97.3% of water is stagnated in the ocean areas. So this is, how is this water in sea? Too salty, it is saline. That water does not useful for our daily needs. Remaining water, only 2.7%. this is the fresh water available for us. Okay, so water is absolutely essential for our survival. It can fresh our thirst when we are thirsty. If you are wasting this water, how can you live in your future? That is the big question arise in your brains. Okay. Children, in this video, I explained only the water cycle and the distribution of water. How you get the water? These things we discussed in this video. In the next lesson, we will learn more about water. Thank you, children. Bye.